Dear CG thinkers, welcome! Are you a hard surface enthusiast but lacking inspiration? Or maybe you're just both fluent and you would like to practice? You are on the right place for a hard surface modeling tutorial with Blender and the Fluent addon. Just before getting started, I show you my Fluent preferences. I use the circular menu and I don't use the click hold option. Don't forget that the keys are displayed at the bottom of the screen, so you can't miss anything I do. We agree on the basics? Generic.
Scifi, talk, share knowledge, grow together.
Display the grid on the floor with a right click. Choose the shape tool and draw an L. Once finished, shift left click to validate the shape and move the mouse to add thickness. Next, we add a first bevel. We want a straight shape, so I click to bring up the menu and choose the straight option. I use the menu, but for long-time users, I will let you use the shortcut specified in bracket on each button. Validate this adjustment and continue with a second bevel, which will also be straight. Click to display the menu, then click on straight. You will notice that this isn't quite what we want. As a reminder, this is the objective. The trick is to modify the value of the limit angle. Increase this value to around 50 for correct effect. I find the model a bit thick, so I'm reducing it before moving on. We finalize the basic shape by editing a bevel using the F key menu. Once again, the bevel isn't exactly where we want. It's about of angle limits. In this case, I modify to 30 degrees. One last thing about the bevel. I find it a bit wide, so I'm reducing its size. The basic shape is done. The fun can begin. Let's move to the side and call out the inset tool. Click on the top of the face, a little below the bevel, and draw a thin rectangle. Click to validate the drawing. Move the mouse to the left to start cutting and press V to cross the whole model. Please remember that the core of my addon is to be non-destructive. So if you are not happy with your cut, don't delete it. Don't escape. Don't control Z. Just edit it. You can use the G key to move the object. You can press Tab to enter in edit mode and use the S key to modify its dimensions. In short, there is no reason to delete the shape and start again. We will continue with the other part of the L with a slice. If you display the grid, you can see that it extends over the face, but I would like it to be drawn only on the face I've clicked on, so I deactivate the extend button. I keep my new object selected. Press the F key and call up the tool for editing screw heads. I'm now in edit mode. Select the face and press enter. I click to bring up the menu, click on change. I choose the cruciform head, then the type head 0. You can see that for me, the screws are immediately in the right place and size. This may not be the case for you. You can use the move and scale buttons to adjust them correctly. Use the I/O button to push the screw heads inside the plate. We're done with the screw, we're moving on to a new rectangular cut. I display the grid and draw a rectangle whose top and bottom edges are close to the previous cut. The following technique is what I call cut the cutter. We will cut our object, which itself does the cutting. I hold down the shift key and click on the little pencil, which will relaunch Fluent on the object we were editing. This avoids having to exit and relaunch Fluent. Let's display the grid by right-clicking on the surface and draw a centered rectangle using the central point of the grid and using the shift key. Next, we proceed with an array adjustment. Use the red dot to activate the tool on this axis in order to adjust the spacing between repetitions. Press the C key to switch to adjust the number of repetitions. Reuse the C key as many times as you want to switch between adjustments. Left click to end actions along the axis, then use the middle button to validate. Next, we move on to a slice in the orthographic view. If you're new to Blender, know that we can select the orientation of your view with the 1, 3 or 7 keys. And if you combine them with the control key, you will go to the opposite views. For example, the 1 key set the front view and control 1 combination set the back view. Use the slice tool in the Fluent menu and select the shape tool. Click halfway up the grid that you just created, then hold down the control key to ensure that the line is straight and continue your drawing like me. You will notice that I keep the control key pressed throughout the operation to use the snap system. The only adjustment you're going to add is a first bevel to round the corners. Next, we add a grid. After displaying the famous Fluent blue grid, draw a rectangle like this and kit. Fluent's grid tool requires selecting a Boolean object beforehand. To display Boolean objects, you can either use the keyboard shortcut you have set in the preferences or use the pie menu, where you will find a button in the top section. Once the object is selected, press the F key to call up the grid menu. The first step is to choose the type of grid. I will keep it simple and use the diamond pattern grid. We make some adjustments, like the size of the grid using the scale button. You can also modify the position of the grid more or less inside the cut. Feel free to take some liberty with the tutorial. Try other adjustments, try other grids, have fun and let's continue. We are going to create a support for our object, which will be an opportunity to use the plate tool. It's very simple. Just select the face and press the Enter key. Adjust the thickness and exit. Now, I propose a manipulation that will certainly interest you because it is a common case. Select the bottom part of the object, use the cutting tool and display the grid. Use the circle tool either by clicking on the button or using the C key. Here is a great opportunity to discover the new tool that was added in 2.2.0 update of Fluent, the frame. On launch, you will start by adjusting the depth. By calling up the menu, you can adjust other parameters, such as the frame width. Finish by adjusting the offset to bring the frame closer to the cut. I find the cut look like low poly. In Fluent, there is a handy tool that allows you to avoid having to adjust resolution object by object. Press the F key and click on the gears. Here you can set the general resolution of your model. By default, they are quite low. I suggest you set 32 as the minimum cylinder resolution. The result seems much more correct. Now let's have a look at the duplication tool. Display Boolean objects. Select the last one created, press the F key and call up the duplication tool. Move over the object and left click to drop a copy of your object. Right click to exit the tool. How's that for handy? You will have understood that the idea of this tutorial is to use several tools. And we continue with the use of pipes. Press the Ctrl key and click in the cuts to position the pipe ends. I start by adjusting the size of the pipe, the radius, so that it fits into the cut. The next adjustment changes the pipe's trajectory. I choose it to follow the shape of the object more closely. I find the corners too wide, so I reduce their radius. I think it's nicer. Here is how to add a few rings. To do this, go to the extra section of the menu, then the ring button and finally the add button. You can use the menu to move the ring or change its length. I continue with the addition of a new ring, which I position elsewhere with a different length, and I create an array. If you wish to return to another ring, press the R key to move from one ring to another. You will see that the selected ring moves. I've kept the best for last, because otherwise you would already be gone. It's time to cut for your fabric banner. Use the cutter and press the face inset button. Select the top face and press the I key. By moving your mouse, you will be able to make this inset face. Left click to validate the shape and press enter to complete the operation. The selected face has been transformed into a Fluent object, allowing us to cut and add a frame. Now comes the moment you've been waiting for. Keep your object selected. Press the F key and call up the Cloth Panel tool. Select the background face and press Enter to enjoy the simulation before your amazed eyes. Okay, I'm making a bit deal of it, and I don't know about you, but for me, it's always a pleasure to see the simulations. A final touch for detail and practice. Stand here and make a simple cut in the center of the face. Using the Array tool, click on the axis and move the mouse to set the gap, then use the C key to set the count. If you didn't get it the first time, now I hope that's understood. Use the left mouse button to confirm operations on the axis and the middle button to confirm. Display and select the Boolean object we've just created and go to the other side of the object. Use the F key and call up the duplication tool to place a copy of this object on this face. If the object is not properly oriented, use the R key to rotate it. Well, there you have it. A good hard surface exercise that allowed us to use a vast array of tools. In fact, I did the math for you. We used 4 different cutting tools, 5 different adjustments for cuts, screw heads, pipe, ring on pipe, grid and fabric panel. All in all, we clicked about 20 different buttons. I hope you didn't just watch me, but that you also practiced and are happy with what you produced. Feel free to share your creation on social networks and on the Discord. I'm always glad to see what you've produced. Don't forget to subscribe, the bell, and all that. See you next time, and don't forget, we get tired of everything except learning. Bye bye.